ही इज द फाउंडर ऑफ ऑल कार्गो लॉजिस्टिक्स. नाम तो सुना होगा, अगर नहीं सुना तो सुनो, मैं बताता हूँ. ठीक है, ऑल कार्गो लॉजिस्टिक्स हैज ग्रोन टू बी अ ग्लोबल लीडर इन इंटीग्रेटेड लॉजिस्टिक्स सॉल्यूशंस, ऑपरेटिंग इन ओवर 160 कंट्रीज विद 300 प्लस ऑफिसेस, हाउसिंग मोर देन 8,500 टीम. ऑल कार्गो इज द लार्जेस्ट मोस्ट एसोसिएटेड नेम इन द लॉजिस्टिक इंडस्ट्री. And yes, Mr. Shashi Kiran Shetty has been conferred with the highest civilian honor from Belgium. Lifetime contribution to the Freight Award at Global Freight Awards 2015 London. Actually, they get awards every year. I have only two names. I said, let's take a name of the awards. And yes, Mr. Shashi Kiran Shetty is an unstoppable force in the Indian business area. Itna hi nahi, he's a sports enthusiast and an avid golfer. So presenting to you, our first speaker of numero 6, Mr. Shashi Kiran Shetty.
Hello, sir. Hello.
How are you?
I'm good, good. How are you doing?
Thank you so much, sir, for joining us. How are you feeling? How are you?
I'm feeling very good. I'm feeling like you, young and energetic.
Oh, yes. You're younger than me, sir. You're younger than me.
Feeling young, not looking young like you.
Are sir, aap aise zyada young dekh rahe ho. Trust me, I'm telling you.
Oh, really? Thank you for that.
So, sir, I want to thank you so much for joining us. And I don't want to take any more time. I know you have something with you and you want to address our students. So let's begin and then I'll shoot my questions to you.
Oh, sure. Okay.
Okay. So good luck, right, sir. Actually, mujhe good luck ki zyada zarurat hai, but yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And first of all, good afternoon, everybody. My best wishes to each one of you. Stay safe. Don't party too much. Look after the elders in the house.
We don't party, sir. We don't party. We are very sharif.
That's great. And, do as much studies as you can online and develop new skills. This is the great time that you have to learn new things, which is outside the box, what we say in our industry. Learn outside the box and think outside the box and make it skillful and something which will come handy in the future. I'm sure you must have heard this enough, that time is one asset. Once it is gone, it is never ever going to come back. So make the most out of your time and use it well, your own development, without forgetting the community. All these things I'm saying because we all make progress, building community, building the nation, and taking care of the world to the best extent possible, both as environment and as contributors to the world's sustainability, right? And spread good messages, good values, and spread good behavior, and make the world a better place to live for, not only for you, also for the future generations to come. I think this is one of the very, very important things, I think, many of us probably don't keep in mind. So this is one message I think you should carry all the way in your life. No matter how big, how successful, how much you achieve in life. End of the day, all education, all the success, all the fame that we earn should be used for the welfare of humanity and the future of this universe. So that is my first message to all of you. I just want to say that in my own humble way, I've been able to achieve a lot. It was beyond my imagination when I moved to Bombay at the age of 21 from a small town outside Mangalore city, looking for a job without a godfather. Fortunately had a place to live with my sister who gave me a lot of support. I stayed with her for 2 years and worked in a shipping agency company, knowing nothing about shipping, fascinated by the industry, just for the fact that I had to meet different nationals who used to work in the ships and the people who used to come and visit us in our offices at the company where I used to work. And the very fact that you get exposure to different languages, different cultures, and knowing and working in the port for the shipping company, it was a joy. It was so large and so fascinating. That was something that I'm extremely proud about and very much remember those early days of my career. Most importantly, I'm so glad that I'm happy, I'm peaceful, I have a great family. And all these, I believe, are because of the hard work, the sincerity and extremely focused approach, and most importantly, using common sense. You know, there is no rocket science leading life. I want to insist this that along with common sense also makes you a company, gives you a company of right people. Right people are very important to surround yourself with, because you learn from them, remain your friends, they are there for you, and you have fun with them. And they help you each other, right, in your career and as you move forward. The other most important thing is, like I said earlier, is in an organization also, you know, it's you have to build the right culture. Right culture can only be brought in by practicing high quality values. What is relevant when you are in an organization or when you are doing business? You exist for your customer, right? And customer centricity is one of the very critical factor when you work in an organization. Have integrity, have innovation. You know, these are some of the very important values that one always need to practice in your professional life, or even, you know, student life. So what does all this say? Whatever I said so far, what does it say? If you have some amount of luck, obviously, you have to be at the right place at the right time. With the hard work, you can achieve miracles. I mean, you can achieve things with what I have been able to achieve, right? So the message I'm trying to give is, with the hard work, with the sincerity, with the right values, and being in the right place at the right time, you can achieve a lot in life, okay? Everybody may not be able to do it, build a billion-dollar company or build a large empire, but that doesn't matter. That's not the only thing which leads to success. Many rich people may be not happy, maybe not peaceful. Money doesn't only the success factor, right? What is success is happiness, impact you make to the society, and what kind of a family that you develop and build, right? So that's is a real success. As far as business building, organization building is concerned, in my experience, is always about, you know, getting into a business which is scalable, getting into a right structure in the organization, having a kind of a strategy, how to implement those 3 to 5 years plans. Along with that, have a right amount of courage and conviction about what you really need to do, right? The critical part is, as you build an organization into a scale, it is very important that one has to also have the right structure, right balancing of the systems and processes to make sure that your business is sustainable. You don't get into surprises. Like I said, customer centricity. When you grow, you cannot be in front of the customer all the time. You have to build an organization. You have to build an ecosystem to manage customer centricity. So that means you got to have right kind of a people and very clear job that has been defined, who's supposed to do what. Otherwise, it will become like a commotion. It is like a confusion state, right? You got to have that clarity and got to have that job description for people to do their job in a time-bound manner, and, you know, also have the right kind of a goals and processes to assess the performance of the people and reward them, show them the future path, where they're going to go in their career, in your organization, so that they are motivated to remain committed to your organization and they get compensated and get the job satisfaction in what they do. So these are the kind of a culture building, structure building, which is important, right? So, I'm sorry, there is a noise. Sorry, today is my daughter's birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Thank you. There is some, my brother and my wife and my cousins, we are all living together to celebrate a birthday. They kind of are playing the music in setting it up.
Okay.
Yeah. So end of the day, why would customer come to you? Why would people come to you? Because they have to trust you, right? So the trust factor is extremely important. And trust factor can only be developed with the living your promises through action, right? People believe your action, but they will believe you more when those promises are kept. So trust building in an organization is also extremely critical. As an organization, what we've been able to achieve in being an Indian company, which has never been done in our country, to build an India organization, which is now representing in every part of the world with our own offices mostly. Of course, we also work with quite a few agents. And we did that with a lot of thinking and a lot of acquisitions. And when you do acquisitions, obviously you need to put a lot of capital, right? The banks don't fund you for acquisition, okay? Only private equity and public market gives you finance for acquisition. Obviously, when they look at your acquisition appetite, somebody, especially me, who never acquired a company in the past, there had to be a business model which had to sustain that, right? So the investors have to see value in that. So it's very critical that you do your entire business planning along with financial planning. Otherwise, you know, those two go in different directions, you're not going to meet your purpose. So we raised money from private equity and from public market almost four times. You know, that money we used for growing the business globally and also within the trade. I'm very happy to say that we now employ almost well over 10,000 people. Out of that, almost 4,500 are outside India. So which means we have to manage multicultural workforce, and that is a task by itself, right? Managing a European organization and a Chinese organization and an Australian organization versus an African and a Middle Eastern organization is very, very different. So, you know, that needed a lot of thinking. And one thing I always did is continuously kept learning by reading books, by attending seminars, by going to university. I went back to Harvard to do my owner's president program, staying there for 3 weeks or 3 years and learned a lot there. Like I said, I associated with great people who are good advisors, great legal mind, great financial mind, great HR mind. I'm very happy to also say that we are on a transformation exercise where we are working with McKinsey to help the organization to transform our group for the next challenges of the future, which is the digitalization, which is disrupting our industry as well. So with this, I will stop here, and I'm happy to take some questions.
Yes, sir. I'm going to come to a few pointers from your speech. But before that, sir, I really want to ask one of my questions. That is, when I was going through your interviews, you said that one of the major factors which you build your business, the whole business, was relationships. Take care.
Yeah.
So the relationship factor is very important for you, but the definition of relationships has changed. Okay. Like for us, it's like, you know, we'll have fun, but then tum apne raaste mein apne se, and your people are like sharks. No one's going to help each other.
Okay. Let me ask you a counter question. Don't you love your parents?
I love them.
I loved my parents too.
Yeah.
I have friends. You love your friends?
I do.
And trust your
friends? No, I don't.
You don't trust your friends. You don't have a friend who you can trust.
I have friends whom I can trust. But what I'm saying is there are certain circumstances. There's this constant fear. Ki, you know, he's my friend or that you are my friend. And you know, ki wo kabhi bhi chala ja sakta. Like, you know, he can just kaat ke chala jayega.
I'll tell you. You know, I think if you read the history.
Yeah.
Okay. Traitors were there even in the history. Right. That does not mean the world has not moved forward. The world has moved forward. There are a lot of good people out there.
Yeah.
Okay. And there are a lot of bad people out there. But most people are good. I can guarantee you that. And, you know, the trust is two-way traffic. It is not one-way traffic. Right. So, you see, and end of the day, what happens is everybody is not a competitor. Yeah. There are people who work in your customer's offices. They may be your friends. Okay. There, if you know people, he will help you. But you may have a friend who started something what you do, for example. Or you have a friend who works in the same organization. Both of them are competing for the same job.
Yeah.
So there, of course, you have to be careful. You have to be careful with your competitor. But you have a friend who's outside your, you know, outside your organization, who works for your customer. So there he can help you, right? So networking is very important. That's relationship building. Right. and respect people, trust people, help people. That's the most important thing. You know, selflessly help people if you can. I'm not saying help people with money, but help people with anything. Smile at people, a simple thing. Please, 5 people a day, give somebody 100 rupees, or, you know, that always comes back. The ecosystem, we're all part of the human ecosystem, right? The cosmic ecosystem. So we need to believe in humanity. We need to trust people. We need to trust, you know, like brothers, our sisters, our family members, trust your friends.
Okay. I'll agree on that. Even audience questions are coming in. So audience question mein puchne wala. But before that, sir, I was again going through one of your interviews, and you told you were telling there ki you used to be part of college clashes. Okay. So like, can you tell me one of those college clashes which you remember, one clash, and any tips on winning those clashes? Like,
You mean clash in the sense we used
to, I don't know. You were talking about college clashes.
Yeah. I was running for the presidency of my college association during my younger days, right? We had an issue with the teaching staff in the college, okay? And obviously, a lot of students were very unhappy with what was going on with the management of the university, of the college where I was studying. Yeah. So we decided to protest. Okay. So that protest led to something which shouldn't have happened. There were untoward incidents that happened. And, you know, so at that time, we thought that we were doing the right thing. But, you know, we were immature. We were students, young people, right? We don't know. So we got into that situation and got into trouble at home and in the college. So anyway, I'm lucky that I overcame that.
Yeah.
And I always stood by my friends or my people who trusted me, you know. And
that's
I fought
the pro
for
tip
them.
Of winning the clash.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay. But I think those clashes made you what you are right now. And that's a great person.
A matter of courage. You know, I think as leadership, one of the most important qualities also to have courage, right? Courage to do what you truly believe you need to do. You know, it may be very difficult. If you put yourself out of the comfort zone, right? And you know, go through that situation if you have to. You have no other choice. A lot of people avoid that.
Yeah.
People are not against change, but they forget that change is inevitable, right? Lord Krishna said in Bhagavad Gita that, you know, change is inevitable. You cannot stop the change. Change will come always. And if you don't change, we are where we are. We are not going to improve.
True.
They're not going to remain relevant.
Oh, yes. Relevant. Yeah. So like there are a lot of audience questions which we are getting. Okay.
Sure.
I have this question from Manas. Manas says that if you were in my shoes right now, a first year student, what would you be investing in and what would you be doing right now if you are a first year student now?
I think, you know, one of the subjects I definitely would like to study and understand, everything is important, okay? I think one of the most important thing today is about digitalization, right? The whole world is moving towards automation, IoT, blockchain, artificial intelligence. This is becoming a very important area which will change the world, change how we study, how we work, and how we live our life, right? Some amount of skill development in the area of these technology, even if you are a commerce student or even if you are a, you know, I'm not saying you be a coder, you don't have to, but you should know the whole digitalization, the computer science to some extent. I'm probably not using the right word, but so this is one of the change, right?
Yeah.
Have to adopt that change, not only to use Instagram, right? So you need to go beyond Instagram. Instagram is for your fun purposes, right? And of course, you can also use it for business. So you should know how to leverage the technology. Basically, that's the point I'm trying to make, right? Okay. A lot of people have made a lot out of Instagram for the business gain. Or a career aspiration. You're an Instagram influencer, for example, right? So how you leverage technology is something I think very important for everyone to know to some whatever extent that is required in our own career.
Okay. And then here we have got one job like question. What do you look for in an employee?
Yeah, drive, skill, of course, education, right? Hunger, appetite to grow, appetite to do well.
Okay. Okay.
Obviously, the character is given, right? Character is given.
Yeah. So, sir, this is my question. What I want to ask you is, aggressive businessman, calculated risk taker, bold decisions, and a strong vision. Okay.
Yes.
These words, they look good in textbooks. Okay.
Yes.
But
we
all will agree that you have all those qualities, and even you agree because you tell everyone that, you know, I have these qualities, and because of them, I have made this business. Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
Tell me now, you are in 160 countries. How did you build those qualities when you were in zero? Like, because you're telling it and building them inside, it's a huge difference.
Okay. Yes.
Everyone wants to make a difference in the world. You know, I want to make an impact in the world so that people can recognize. That's a strong vision.
Yes.
But I won't be able to do it. What did you do?
Learn every single minute. Learn from everybody. Learn from your son. Learn from your daughter. Learn from your servant. Learn from your teacher, your friend. You know, learn. Have great appetite for knowledge. Right?
Yeah.
And have a self-belief that you can do it. Right? And the vision comes, you know, when you have a focus, a very, very sharp focus on, you know, your business, your work. Like I said, you know, it's never satisfied, because also, you know, maybe to some extent, my business is also such that it is a very fragmented business. We have at least about 6 different employees left our company and started on their own business, right? We have overseas companies came here and disrupted their agent and came and started their own. So there was a tremendous amount of insecurity that I had. And insecurity is good. Insecurity drives you. You know, that is why, you know, people from small towns do far more successfully. Look at cricket, or you look at many of the success stories, right? Yeah. So people from smaller towns who are many times very high aspirational, right?
True.
So why? Because, you know, in bigger cities, particularly the richer sides, are, unless you have a business, a lot of people are very well brought up and very much in the family business and taken the business to next level. But you know, that focus, that hunger, and continuous learning is very important for success, what I very firmly believe in.
True.
And, you know, because no university can teach like that, prepares you for the battle. But university, you don't battle, right? You learn from other people's battle. Here you have to do your own battle. So for you to do a real battle, you have to all learn, because techniques change. The whole system changes.
Yeah.
The rules changes. Business to business, company to company, sector to sector.
You know, you being so aggressive businessman, still there's this one point which hit me hard. You said ki a lot of people are not peaceful. But when I was talking to you, you were like, you're quite peaceful and you're quite happy and peaceful.
Yes.
Why? Like, what do you think? Like, why is that possible? Because a lot of rich people and a lot of people who have the drive, who are doing something, they're actually not peaceful.
Yeah. No, I think first of all, you know, you must have a very deep family connection, because, you know, end of the day, we're all human beings, right? We need love. We need attention, right?
Hmm.
So the family keeps you grounded, number one. I come also from a very humble family, a very honorable family. So our upbringing also has been very good. And, you know, I'm a very spiritual person. I'm a person who focus a lot on fitness, both physical and mental. Okay, from very young days, I used to go to the temple. I used to get up early morning, go to swim, go to temple, go to college,
golf.
Used to play cricket. I learned golf much later, of course. So in that way, I balanced my life well. End of the day, the life is not only about work. It also has many other things which you must experience, right?
Yeah.
So fitness is important for me, both mental and physical. Sports is important to me because that helps you to forget about your day-to-day pressures. Family is very important to me. Go out on, with your family on vacation is very important to me. I took two family vacations every year without fail from the time I married. Okay. I live in a nice house. I have a nice office. I create a good work environment, family environment. I obviously don't do anything excess. I have a drink, always within limits.
Sir, I hope so. You enjoyed, and thank you so much for joining us. Any last thing? How was it? How did you feel? Numero six.
No, it's wonderful, wonderful. I'm really having fun here.
So thank you so much, sir.
I hope all your fellow students have gained something out of it and
definitely, sir. We all are the same age group. If I've learned, I'm interesting you that everyone is learning the same and they all enjoyed. So thank you so much, sir. I hope we meet again.
Look forward. Thank you, Akash. All the best. Sir.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.